Mark chapter 5. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Jesus. I love you, Jesus.
Bless your
word. Oh, I worship your name, God.
Yes.
Oh, I bless your name, God. Hallelujah.
Bless your word.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Somebody else, I feel like something's about to happen.
Okay.
Hallelujah. I feel like God's about to change some stuff around. Hallelujah. He's about to reconstruct some stuff.
Okay.
Hallelujah. God's about to show up. In the middle of your situation, see somebody praying for God to move, and God says, the wait is over. I'm about to show up in the middle of your situation. I'm about to change stuff. I'm about to turn things around. He says, I'm still the God of the turnaround. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Hallelujah. I'm feeling in the atmosphere. I'm feeling in the atmosphere.
Thank you, Father. Lord.
Mark chapter 5.
Yes.
Verse 21. When you have it, please stand. Mark chapter 5, verse 21.
Yes.
Bless your word.
Bless your word, God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Jesus.
And when Jesus was passed over again, by ship unto the other side.
All right.
Much people gathered unto him, and he was nigh unto the sea.
Uh-huh.
And behold, there cometh one of the rulers of the synagogue, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet.
All right.
And besought him greatly, saying, my little daughter lieth at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay thy hands on her, that she may be healed, and she shall live.
Jesus.
And Jesus went with him, and much people followed him and thronged him. And a certain woman, which had an issue of blood 12 years,
all right,
and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse.
Jesus. Wow.
When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment.
Yes.
For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole.
Amen. Amen.
And straightway, right away, immediately, the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague.
Healed.
Yes.
And Jesus immediately, knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, "Who touched my clothes?"
Come on.
And his disciples said unto him, "Thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou, who touched me?" Mm-hmm. And he looked around about to see her that had done this thing.
Jesus.
But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth.
Yes, yes.
And he said unto her, "Daughter, thy faith has made thee whole.
Faith.
Go in peace and be whole of thy plague."
Jesus.
While he yet spake, there came from the ruler of the synagogue's house certain which said, "Thy daughter is dead. Why trouble the master any further?"
My God.
As soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he said unto the ruler of the synagogue, "Be not afraid, only believe."
Only
believe. Be not afraid, only believe. Let us pray. Father God, we praise your name. Lord, we worship you. We magnify your name. You are worthy to be praised. We give you the glory, the honor, and the praise just because of who you are. We thank you, Lord, for your love, your mercy, your grace, your favor, God. We thank you, Lord, for your power, God. We thank you for your word today, God. Teach us, oh God. Speak to us, invigorate us, enlighten us, empower us, heal us, deliver us through your word on today, God. In the name of Jesus, change souls, change lives, set the captives free, open the eyes of the blind, heal the sick, oh God. Edify the hungry, oh God. Encourage the discouraged on today, God. Lord, we just thank you for breaking every chain, God. And Lord, we just praise your name, God, for your power in this house, God. We bind up the spirit of Satan. We come against every demon on assignment against this assignment, God. We thank you, Lord, that Father God, captives will be set free, God, from demonic oppression, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, have your way. Have your way. Somebody shout, have your way.
Have your way.
Have your way, Lord. Have your way. Have your way. And at the end of this time, we'll be ever so certain to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. And it's in the precious Master's name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, that we pray. And let the church say, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
As you take your seat, tell somebody something's about to change.
Something's about to change.
Hallelujah. 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 Something is about to change.
Amen.
And some of us are due for change. We've been going through a lot. Some of you, God showed me in the spirit realm. Some of you have been going through so much. And you know, you're almost like the title. There's a movie that came out and said, "Something's got to give."
Uh-huh.
And you're almost at the point where you're like, "God, something's got to give.
Yeah.
I can't take it no more. I don't feel like I can handle this no more. Something's got to give. God, I need you to move." Anybody been feeling like you need God to move in the middle of your situation? Hallelujah. I need you to move. Hallelujah. You strong. You've been enduring a lot, but it's time for something to change.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's time for your breakthrough. Hallelujah. It's time for your miracle. It's time for your deliverance. It's time, oh glory, for your prosperity. Hallelujah. It's time for things to be put in order. It's time for you to have some peace in your mind. Hallelujah. It's time for you to have some peace in your home. It's time for you to have some peace in the middle of that relationship. Something is about to change.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
But he had chains on the inside. He had some bondage on the inside that he could not break free from. He had some bondage on the inside that he could not break free from. Hallelujah. And his bondage would have him in the tomb in the middle of the night where most people would be sleeping. He would be crying out. He was up there making noise and howling and screaming and making all kinds of noises and cutting himself and hurting himself in the tombs. Hallelujah. So Jesus had gone over to the other side by divine appointment to deliver this man.
Amen.
Because no matter how bad we are and how much is going on with us, it's not God's desire to leave us like that. You see, when we're tormented by the devil, God will intervene. Hallelujah. And Jesus went over by divine intervention to make a difference in this man's life. The Bible said by the time Jesus finished casting out the devil, casting out the demons, that this man who was naked when he ran up to Jesus was sitting there clothed and in his right mind. Sometimes they take away your inhibitions. Hallelujah. And sometimes you Because even though I was having fun, see, the devil's a great deceiver. He's a great deceiver.
See,
and even though I was having what I thought was fun out there and the clubs and doing what I was doing and even in the, and some of the relationships that I was in, I spent a lot of nights crying.
Legit.
Hallelujah. Show you the legit.
My God.
So God, and I was looking for the If I go to hell, I'm going from the boss, dude. I'm not going to church for the, I'm not going to hell for the church pew. But see, I didn't realize that the people who were still sitting in the church had something I didn't have. They had Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, God will bear with you until you get it together. Somebody say grace.
Grace.
Come on, somebody say thank you, Jesus, for grace.
Thank you for grace.
Yes. church like this no more. And like that, give me a deeper revelation for God to know. I need you to get the basics. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I need you to know me. I need you to know what I have for you. See, I often tell people, as long as you have your boyfriend in your bed or your girlfriend in your bed, God can't send you your husband or your wife. As long as it's outside of his will.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. I don't know why I'm here, but God wants to do a divine intervention. Tell somebody something has got to change.
Something's
got to
change.
Tell somebody something's getting ready
to change.
God took away the money. And why relationship? Why relationship? Because relationships are the biggest headache. Hallelujah. Relationships are what drives us to drink sometimes. Solution. situation where you just needed somebody who will understand, or you needed somebody that can tell you what to do, but the situation did not get better, it got worse.
Got worse.
And that was the situation for this woman. She went looking. The Bible said she spent all her money, everything that she had, trying to find the cure for the sickness that had come upon her.
Amen.
The Bible said she had an issue of blood for 12 years.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but I know my sisters in the house can relate and say we can't stand that issue for 5 days, let alone 12 years. Change.
my God.
To receive from Jesus. She had to expect to receive from Jesus. She had to go to him and pull on the anointing that was on his life. She had to go to him in faith and say, Jesus, I heard that you healed my auntie. I heard that you healed my pastor. I've seen you deliver some folk from this before. says that as soon as Jairus and Jesus heard the testimony of the woman with the issue of blood,
amen,
the devil came in the form of people coming from Jairus' house saying, why bother her him anymore? Your daughter is dead.
Jesus.
The girl is dead.
Yes, God.
The Bible says Jesus ignored them. And he said, no, 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 don't worry about them. Don't you be afraid.
Wow.
Yes.
Amen. Jesus.
broken. Every spirit of bondage, broken. Fill out.
Yes, God.
They ask you your medical history. Amen. They ask you your family's medical history. Amen. And the reason they do that is because there's a trend. There's a pattern. There's a way that things tend to happen through the bloodline. Because I know God is going to do something today. I know God is going change that situation today. Some of y'all know y'all need money. You know you need that new apartment. You know you need your relationship. There was a time you never argued. Now all you do is argue. And God is saying, you need a change. There was a time you used to have fun. You had joy. And people said, why do you smile so much? Why do you have so much laughter? And now you see yourself with a serious look all the time. And God is saying to you today, this woman with the issue got to change. The man with the demons got to change. Even after Jairus' daughter was dead, he got to change. So when we pray today, God is going to do something. God is going to turn that relationship around. Pastor, you touched on something so mighty. I don't want to go, I'm sorry, but I don't want to go to church if that church is not going to help me. I'm just sorry. I need relevant, real preaching because I got real problems. I need real answers because I got real trouble. You ready to pray? Come on and pray. Somebody about to get a breakthrough. Somebody about to get a change. You've been having pain in your body. You've been having trouble sleeping at night. You know your marriage is in trouble. But when pastor pray, even being single and just having that flesh being weak, God will touch you today. In Jesus' name.
Lift those hands to the Lord. Hallelujah. Father God, we praise your name. Lord, we worship you.
Father, even as Pastor touched them, in the mighty name of Jesus, we know that she has the anointing on her life today. So Lord, even as she touched his little daughter in Zion, I thank you for Kennedy. I thank you for supernatural protection over her life. Thank you for her mom and her dad. I thank you for her grandmother. I thank you as you keep her safe this summer in the name of Jesus, that you will protect this family. Sister Dolores P. Tucker, in the name of Jesus, even as the anointing of God is on my wife's life, as she laid hands, in the mighty name of Jesus, God, that you would heal her from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, do it. Around. Oh, glory be to God. Touch this family in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we thank you. We anoint you in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord, we say, have your way. Glory be to God in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch God. Oh, according to your will. Bless her in the name of Jesus. Anoint.
We bind up, Father God, spirit of Father God, any activity that's outside of you, oh God. We speak peace over her mind, oh God. She will be able to sleep at night, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we come against nightmares, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for that hedge of protection over her life. That Jesus, by the name we pray. We thank you for her family, Lord. We thank did not come in. We did not have your children. The generation are saved. God says, I declare that word over your life. And I seal my word today. I seal my word over your life. And Jesus, my name. Amen. Strongholds off of her life, God. We thank you for that issue, oh God. Oh, we pray for strongholds on you right now. Oh, Lord, hallelujah. That thing keeps trying to come back and make you mad, make you hurt, make you angry. I break it off. I break its power. I break its power. Oh, I break its power in the name of Jesus. I break its power. I declare peace over your life. I declare peace over your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
replenishing. We thank you for restoration. And we thank you for renewing her spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. And we say amen. And we agree that it's God. In Jesus' name. There's nothing that bothered Jesus more than the unbelief of those in which he had the opportunity to disciple while he walked this earth. Amen. The Bible says when Jesus was on his ship sleeping and a storm arose and the winds and the waves came and beat against that boat, and they woke him up saying, "Don't you care if we perish?" The Bible says, Jesus asked them, "Ye of little faith, why did you not believe?" Amen. Even in a time when they could not cast out the demon out of the boys, out of the father's little boy who was demonically possessed. Amen. The Bible says, Jesus rebuked them and Jesus chastised them for their unbelief. She's all right? Okay, to God be the glory. She need water, anything? Okay, to God be the glory. Amen. That's just church, church. To God be the glory. Everything that go on, we don't understand it. Sometimes we can't figure God out, but we all have our own individual walk with God. And our own individual deliverance and however he wants to deliver us. Amen. So she got her breakthrough today. She got delivered today. Amen. To God be the glory. And the third thing that I want to point out, even as he was risen from the dead, Jesus rebuked them for their unbelief because of the miracles, because of the order, and because of the things that he told them in prophetic utterances that they must believe before it happened. And when you partake of a service like this, you must believe what you just partook of. Amen. I mean, before the healing is on the medical record, you gotta believe on this end of the healing before it's manifested in the natural. Amen. And that's why Pastor said, if you get home and you don't see change in the natural, believe and you will receive. So it don't matter if you get home and you still got bills, you still unemployed, you still feel pain, it does not matter. Only if you believe will it manifest, and you don't have money, you don't be delivered, you gonna be set free, but you gotta believe God. That's why I just love Joe Osteen. If I had a Bible, this is my Bible. I believe what it says it's I can do. I can believe, I can do, I can be, and I can have. Amen. Pastor said, give me a Bible. Y'all say it with me. Say, this is my Bible. I believe what it says I can do. I believe what it says I can have. And I believe I can have what it says I can have. Amen. I was paraphrasing. I can be, do, and have. Whatever this word says, I can be, do, and have. That's why this is the word church. This is why emotion can't help you when you're unemployed. Emotion can't help you when your spouse is talking divorce. Emotion can't help you during stage 4 cancer. But the word of God, it says that you're healed. It doesn't matter if it's stage 4 or if you're unemployed. You can be, do, and have. Whatever the word says, you can be, do, and have. Amen. And with that said, it's a time to give. Put your hands together. Lord, we give to God. God, go ahead and distribute the envelopes. I just need your attention for a second, church. Malachi chapter 3. We're all familiar with it. Amen. Malachi chapter 3, verse number 8. It says, will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed you? The prophet Malachi says, in tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring me all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house. And prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. In verse 11 says, and I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. Pastor and I on Monday wanted something to eat as I got home from work, and we went to a seafood soul food place named Crockett's in Montclair. And as we went to Crockett's and got our writing, candy ends, and macaroni and cheese, we was going to eat inside the restaurant, but my wife said, or I suggested,